Suicide is a leading cause of death in the U.S. among teens and young adults. More alarming still, sexual minorities or individuals who identify as lesbian, gay, bisexual, queer questioning, or LGBTQ are 2 to 5 times more likely to attempt suicide versus their heterosexual peers. One potential reason why is because of the chronic rejection that they experience in the form of discrimination, bias, and prejudice from society. However, how social rejection leads to increased suicide risk is not well understood, and understanding this link is key to be able to provide tailored interventions to this group of individuals. The aim of my dissertation is to investigate one potential mechanism underlying the relationship between chronic social rejection and suicide risk. Among the general population, social rejection has been found to decrease problem-solving abilities as people have to manage the emotional fallout that follows social rejection. With problem-solving abilities compromised, problems may mount or continue to increase, thereby creating issues for people, and this potentially leading people to think about suicide as a way to end their pain or their stress. Now, individuals who identify as a sexual minority, chronic rejection has been found to increase the emotional fallout of future instances of social rejection, and that potentially leading to even greater problem-solving difficulties, which would then lead to increased suicide risk. However, neither of these models have been tested. And so to test these models using two different but complementary methods, among young adults and sexual minorities, that's kind of where my dissertation comes in. And so in a lab setting, I expose individuals to social rejection in a game that's called Cyberball, where participants play with two of my research assistants. And then I measure problem-solving abilities before and after they experience social rejection. And then my participants complete about a 1 month's worth of surveys on their smartphones to assess their problem-solving abilities, suicide risk, and experiences of social rejection. Ultimately, I hope that my study results will inform intervention efforts among sexual minorities. Thank you.